Let us start a next part of refraction of light through a spherical lenses. Student, you have to draw this diagram, put in front of you, means draw this diagram on the paper, put in front of you. We are studying the further part based on these two diagrams. So you need this diagram again and again. You have to observe the things in this diagram while studying the further part. See here, the difference between convex lens and concave lens. This convex lens is also called as double convex lens. Why it is called as a double convex lens? Because on both sides there is a curve. So it is double convex lens. Concave lens or the double concave lens, on both side there is a curve. So concave lens or double concave lens, convex lens or double convex lens. So what are the differentiating points or what are the concepts related with convex lens and concave lens? So first differentiating point between the convex lens and concave lens, or what is meant by convex lens, what is meant by concave lens. So the definition of convex lens is like this. The lens means it is, the lens is such that which is thicker at the middle and thinner at the edges is called as convex lens. Very simple to understand. A lens which is thicker at the middle and thinner at the edges is called as convex lens. So it is a lens which is thicker at the middle and thinner at the edges. What is concave lens? It is a lens which is thicker at the edges and thinner at the middle. You observe in the diagram. So how the concave lens is? The lens which is thick at the edges and thin at the middle. So such lens is called as concave lens. So these are the first differentiating points, or these are the definitions of convex lens and concave lens. Now, second differentiating point between convex lens and concave lens, it having both surface bulging outward. So this convex lens having both surface bulging outwards. Now concave lens having both surface curved inward. So it having curved surfaces inward. So concave lens having curved surfaces inward. Whereas convex lens having curved surfaces bulging outward. Now next differentiating point, convex lens is a converging lens. It converges the rays to a point. As the convex lens converges the rays at the focus, so it is called as a converging lens. What is concave lens? It is a diverging lens. So it will spread the rays of light. It will divert the rays of light. Hence the concave lens is called as diverging lens. So what is principal focus of a convex lens? Principal focus of convex lens, it is denoted by capital F, and that focal length is denoted by small f. So principal focus of a convex lens, the rays which are falling parallel to the principal axis of convex lens after refraction, after this word is very important, refraction, are converging to a point on the principal axis. This point on the principal axis is called principal focus of convex lens. Student, this is actually a procedure whatever we have used while drawing the diagram. It is the description of your that convex lens diagram, and that will give you the definition of principal focus of convex lens. It is denoted by F notation, like F2. So which is the principal focus of convex lens? It is F2. It is on right hand side, that is F2. The rays which are falling parallel to the principal axis of convex lens after refraction are converging to a point on the principal axis. This point on the principal axis is called principal focus of convex lens. Now, what is the definition of principal focus of concave lens? Look at the diagram. Principal focus of concave lens is your F1 point. So, at which we have shown the dotted line intersection. So, what is principal focus of concave lens? The rays which are falling parallel to the principal axis of concave lens after refraction are appearing to diverge from a point on the principal axis. This point on the principal axis is called principal focus of concave lens. So, what is principal focus of concave lens? If the rays are incident parallel to the principal axis of a concave lens, after refraction, they are appearing to diverge from a point on the principal axis. This point on the principal axis is called principal focus of concave lens. Now, for convex lens, the focal length of convex lens is positive. The focal length of convex lens is positive. As already said to you, here is F2. So, important focus where the convergence takes place, it is F2. So, it is to the right hand side, that is to the positive side of the number line, because optical center is taken as origin. So, focal length for the convex lens is positive. Student, for convex mirror also, focal length was positive. So, convex means focal length positive. It may be a mirror or it may be a lens. Now, focal length for concave lens, here the word required is concave. Focal length for concave lens is negative. So, for concave mirror also, the focal length was negative. So, focal length for concave lens is negative. So, remember, it is similar to the mirror case. Why? Because here the focus which is acting as a diverging focus with respect to which the rays are diverged. It is not F2 focus. It will be a F1 focus. So, F1 focus is on the left side of the optical center, that is to the negative side of the optical center, and negative side from the origin, from the optical center, is taken as negative. Hence, the focal length for the concave lens is negative. Now, study the various terms related with the lens. Look at the diagram. Center of curvature of lens. What is center of curvature of lens? So, center of curvature of lens we have marked as C1 and C2. So, every lens has two spherical surface. Every lens has two spherical surface. Each of these surfaces forms a part of a sphere. Each of these curved surfaces are the parts of a sphere. The centers of these surfaces are called centers of curvature of the lens. It is denoted by C1 and C2. So, I shown you the procedure, how to take the center C1 and C2 while drawing the arc. If you draw a complete sphere, complete circle, taking the center C1 and taking the center C2, you will imagine the spheres. So, if you draw the complete circles around C1 and C2, in case of the convex lens, then the two circles are intersecting to each other. Where they intersect, that point is further named as M and N. That is the size of the lens, that is diameter of the lens, that is called as aperture. And if you are drawing for the concave lens, taking C1 and C2 as a center, the sphere, then that two spheres are separated one. They are not intersecting to each other. In that case also, the size of the lens is shown by MN. Uppermost point is denoted by further M and lowermost point denoted by n, and that is called as the size of a lens, and that is called as the aperture that we are going to study. So let us once again revise the definition. Center of curvature of lens. What is center of curvature of lens? Every lens has two spherical surface. Means these two spherical surface may have different radius or equal radius. Every lens has two spherical surface. Each of these surfaces forms a part of sphere. Each of these surfaces forms a part of sphere. The centers of these spheres are called centers of curvature of the lens. It is denoted by C1 and C2. What is principal axis of lens? An imaginary straight line, an imaginary straight line passing through the two centers of curvature of a lens is called its principal axis. So, an imaginary line which passing through the centers of curvature of lens is called its principal axis. No doubt, this imaginary line further passes through optical center also. So, the line which joins the two centers of curvatures of the lens is called principal axis. What is optical center? Optical center is denoted by O. The central point of a lens is called its optical center. A ray of light passing through optical center without any deviation. The central point of a lens is called its optical center. A ray of light passing through optical center without deviation means a light ray which passes through the optical center, it will pass in the straight path. It is not deviating. Now, focal length of lens is denoted by F notation. So, what is the focal length? In case of mirror, the focal length was the distance from pole to the focus. Here, in place of pole, the point is O, optical center. So, the distance of the principal focus from the optical center of a lens is called focal length. So, it is the distance O to F, that is optical center to principal focus. That distance is called as a focal length. So, we have seen for the convex lens, the focal length is positive, and for concave lens, the focal length is negative. Aperture, the effective diameter of the circular outline of a spherical lens is called its aperture. The effective diameter of circular outline of a spherical lens. So, it is actually a size of the lens. Means, it is the height of the lens, size of the lens. The effective diameter of the circular outline of a spherical lens is called its aperture. So, in further diagram, it is shown by some MN, that is upper part and lower part of the lens, that is called as a aperture. So, next part we will continue in the next slide.